In this next video, we'll discuss the reproductive cycles in human females. Human females have a reproductive cycle, which is a recurring series of events that has three very specific functions. 1. It produces gametes. 2. It makes those gametes available for fertilization. 3. It prepares the female's body for possible pregnancy. The female reproductive cycle is actually two cycles in one. There is the ovarian cycle, which controls the growth and release of an egg cell, and this occurs within the ovaries. And there's also the menstrual cycle, which prepares the uterus for possible implantation of an embryo. Now, these two cycles are synchronized by hormones, which are produced both from the ovaries and also from the woman's brain. So in this diagram, we can see the events occurring within the ovary. These again highlight the ovarian cycle. And we can also see the events occurring with the lining of the uterus. And this is an indication of the menstrual cycle. Both of these charts are using the same approximately 28-day synchronization schedule. Now, one thing to note in both of these cases is that the levels of hormones produced both by the ovaries and by the pituitary gland within the brain, they fluctuate at different points of this process. So let's start at the beginning. At the beginning, there is a production of FSH, or follicle-stimulating hormone, from the pituitary gland. And this is what triggers some of the follicles within the ovary to start maturing, to allow that egg cell to start going through the process of meiosis and prepare it for possible ovulation. Now, as that follicle matures, as that egg cell develops, the follicle starts producing more and more estrogen. And as it's time for that egg cell to be released from the follicle, we see the amount of estrogen production peaking. That peak in estrogen production is going to trigger a sudden release of luteinizing hormone and follicle-stimulating hormone from the pituitary gland, and that is what triggers ovulation. Notice that after ovulation, the remaining cells of the follicles become a structure known as the corpus luteum. This corpus luteum starts producing a different hormone, progesterone, or the pregnancy hormone. This production of progesterone causes a thickening of the inner lining of the uterus, known as the endometrium. So as that progesterone level becomes elevated, the endometrium becomes thicker, waiting for a possible implantation of a developing embryo. If implantation does not occur, the progesterone level will fall, and that's what triggers menses, or the release of the endometrial tissue during the menstrual cycle. The main take-home message about these reproductive cycles is that there are two cycles in one, and they are synchronized by hormones that are coming both from the ovaries themselves, but then also from the pituitary gland. In the next video, we'll talk about some issues of reproductive health and how they relate with human reproductive biology. See you in the next video.